This is T-Bone Walker with Westside Baby. One of the great themes of bringing it all back home is the blues, which is a vernacular music, and I'm interested in vernacular things. I'm interested in things that come from round here, wherever round here is. I like to tell stories about that. I've never ever in my life attempted to do a 1928 discotheque. I can't do it seamlessly like an iPad. One of the oldest of all, and most beautiful of all, and collectible of all record labels is a thing called Sumpit Records. It was run by a woman called Lillian McMurray, who had a furniture shop in Jacksonville, Mississippi. And the greats recorded for Sumpit. Elmore James, Sonny Boy Williamson, Big Joe Williams, anybody who you can name from the Delta at that particular time in the late 40s and 50s, recorded for Lillian McMurray at Sumpit. And this is one of them records. It's like listening to a ghost speaking to you from a machine. As people started travelling away from the Delta to find work in Chicago and Indianapolis and places, they took their music with them. They took the music of the Delta with them. But of course, when they got to the cities, the bars that they went into then were much rowdier and noisier than the bars that they've been used to on. At home, they played on the front porch or they played in little joke joints where, like you're doing tonight, people sat and listened. But when they got to Chicago, the clubs and pubs were much bigger, so they needed to find a louder sound. So in the 1940s, they electrified their sound. In my opinion, the greatest of all bluesmen, Mr. T-Bone Walker. T-Bone was the first to ever put a pickup and an amplifier onto his guitar. And this is on the Comet label, and it's an incredible piece of blues playing from the early years. Intricate patterns he's doing by this time because the electric is allowing him to. It's incredible. Beautiful, eh?